we have ds equals pi times h into delta d plus d into delta h, and we have the particular values. Height of the right circular cylindrical can h equals 6 cm and diameter of the can equals 4 cm. Also, error in measurement of diameter and height is given to be delta d equals 0.1 and delta h equals 0.1. We have ds equals pi times 4 into 0.1 plus 6 into 0.1. That is, ds equals pi times 0.4 plus 0.6, which becomes pi times 1.0. That is, ds equals pi centimeter square. Thus, we have maximum possible error while computing value of lateral surface of right circular cylindrical can is pi centimeter square. Let us discuss an alternate solution for evaluating error in measurement of volume and lateral surface of right circular cylindrical can without depending on concept of differentials. Since we have volume V of the can equals pi d square h by 4, when you take log on both sides of this equation, you get log V equals log of pi by 4 d square h. Since we have log ABC equals log A plus log B plus log C, we have log pi by 4 d square h can be written as log pi by 4 plus log d square plus log h. And we have log d square rewritten as 2 times log d. When you take derivative on both sides of this equation, you have derivative of log v with respect to v is obtained as 1 by v dv. Derivative of log pi by 4 is 0 because this is a constant term. Derivative of 2 times log d with respect to d is obtained as 2 times 1 by d into derivative of d. And derivative of log h equals 1 by h into dh when differentiation is carried out here with respect to h. This equation can be rewritten as dv by v equals 2 times delta d by d plus delta h by h, where we have the particular values delta d equals delta h equals 0.1 and diameter d equals 4 cm, altitude h equals 6 cm. Thus, RHS can be rewritten in this way, and when you multiply volume v to the RHS, we have this equation rewritten in this form. Dv equals pi by 4 times 4 square into 6 into 0.1 into 1 by 2 plus 1 by 6. When you take LCM here, this bracket becomes 3 plus 1 by 6, and thus we have dv equals pi into 4 into 6 into 0.1 into 3 plus 1 by 6. Again, we obtain dv equals 1.6 pi centimeter cube, which is the error in value of volume of the can. We will use the same procedure to check whether error in value associated with measurement of lateral surface of the can is obtained as ds equals pi centimeter square as in the previous method. Since we have lateral surface S of the can is S equals pi dh, when you take log on both sides of this equation, you get log S equals log pi plus log d plus log h. Taking derivative on both sides of this equation, you get ds by S equals 0 plus dd by d plus dh by h, which is because derivative of log pi is 0 since this is a constant. Derivative of log s with respect to s is obtained as ds by s, and derivative of log d with respect to d is obtained as 1 by d into derivative of d. Derivative of log h with respect to h is obtained as 1 by h into dh. When s is multiplied to RHS, we have this equation rewritten as ds equals s multiplied to delta d by d plus delta h by h. Giving the particular values, diameter d equals 4 cm, altitude h equals 6 cm, and delta d equals delta h equals 0.1 cm, we have ds equals pi into 4 into 6 into 0.1 multiplied to 3 plus 2 by 12, which is again obtained as pi centimeter square. Hereby, we have verified error values while computing volume and lateral surface area of the right circular cylindrical can.